This system bringing all of its very heavy rain over parts of the central, the southern plains, the lower Mississippi River Valley. An additional 1 to 3 inches are possible in some areas here because it's such a slow moving system. Flood watches have been issued parts of Oklahoma as well as Texas. Of course, in the Northeast and the 90s, they'll pretty much be confined to the immediate Gulf coastal areas. Look at your overnight readings. I told you, really cooling down over the Northeast behind the surface front, clearing skies, radiational cooling tonight. Oh, temperatures dropping into the 30s. And notice the afternoon highs tomorrow. So today we're talking 50s and 60s, but tomorrow across northern New England, highs only in the 40s and 50s. So definitely cooling. How appropriate, as yesterday was the first day of fall. Today, of course, the first full day of fall, but it certainly feels like it across parts of the Southeast, particularly generally 60s over the Southeast, some 70s along the immediate Gulf Coast. The Northeast, well, Boston, it's 58, 61 in New York, and 56 in Philadelphia, but there is cooler air just north of the border, and actually we have a surface cold front right here that's separating that cooler air. But guess what? This front is going to swing off. Now the forecast for the weekend. Let's begin though with the average afternoon highs at this time of year. And typically we should see readings in the 60s and 70s stacking up like this the farther south in latitude you go. 80s along the Gulf Coast. 90s basically readings over the Northeast in the 50s and 60s, but much colder air just north of the border. And some of this cool air will be coming in tonight behind the surface front as it swings across the Northeast. Day in Atlanta. And it's apropos because yesterday was the first day of fall. Of course, today being the first full day in Canada where readings are in the 30s. And believe it or not, we have a surface cold front right in here separating that cooler air. And as this cold front swings off the New England coast, that's going to allow cooler readings to filter over the Northeast.